Hello, everyone. I'm Tanya Fitzpatrick, one half of the award-winning podcast, World Footprints. And of course, the other half, my husband, Ian, is never far away. He's just behind me. And we're just conquering and dividing during these crazy times. And, you know, I started this video series. It's a passion project of mine. And I started it because I really wanted to connect all of us through our shared common experiences. This COVID-19 virus is like nothing we've ever seen before. And so we're bringing real stories from real people from around the world. And, you know, within the last couple of days, we've heard a lot of concern expressed by the White House task force and other health professionals that they're concerned about new hotspots popping up around the country. And one of those hotspots is Chicago. And so I'm very pleased to invite a friend, Monty Childs, from Chicago to talk about what's really happening on the ground there. So Monty, thank you so much for joining us.
My pleasure, Tanya. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, I wish these were better circumstances. It's always lovely to see you.
Likewise.
So what's really happening in Chicago? I mean, what has happened and how did you guys get to this point of a possibly emerging hotspot with this coronavirus?
Well, I think in Chicago, you have a dense population, maybe not as dense as New York, but a lot of similarities in that aspect. I don't profess to be a health expert, but I think it's just merely a function of the large population that we have here in a dense configuration. And I think, unfortunately, the population here did not take it as seriously early enough. Mm-hmm. And we're behind the eight ball and paying the price now. You know, we pray to God that we don't have any fatalities, and hope that anybody who is hospitalized certainly has as short a stay as possible.
So you haven't had any fatalities at all in Chicago? Because I know throughout...
Oh, we have. We have. I'm not sure what the current number is, but unfortunately there has been a number of fatalities. From a personal standpoint, no one that I personally know, knock on wood, and I do have a friend who has converted his business, which is primarily making lawn furniture, is able to convert it to start manufacturing masks. And in fact, although I'm not wearing it now, whenever I go out, I'm sure to wear the mask that he has sent to me. Mm-hmm. And I was hoping that the parks and the beautiful Chicago lakefront would stay open here. But what happened was the mayor was exasperated about 2 weeks ago how people were not taking the social distancing edict seriously. And she felt like she had no choice but to close down the parks and the lakefronts here. So I try to get out as much as possible using my mask and, of course, using social distancing. But the options are kind of limited. There is a private park that I go to. And oddly enough, one of the things I find myself doing, which I've hated most of my life, is running. I'm just trying to make lemonade out of lemons. But, you know, it's obviously a good way to get out of the house and get some fresh air and an opportunity to maybe get in a little better shape. So that's one of the things I find myself doing during this time that I hadn't done in the past. You kind of learn a little bit more about yourself. And I actually find myself maybe for the first time in my life actually enjoying running.
Oh, excellent. And so I'm assuming that's one of the methods you're using to really de-stress during this stressful time.
Yeah, Tanya, I do it almost every day. And then a few other things that I have been doing recently is I have been picking up my phone and looking up the names of people I have not spoken with in way too long and getting back into contact with them. And that's been a wonderful method to pass the time. And then I guess the other thing that comes to mind is I did upgrade my cable TV package so I can watch more movies.
Oh, bless. I get it. And so that's one of the adjustments then you've made in order to cope with this, with
yes.
all the restrictions.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And I just find, you know, certainly the health issues are a big concern that's causing stress. But, you know, after that, it's like it's the unknown factor. That is, you know, how long is this going to last? I think we could all handle it much better, particularly business owners, if we knew when it's going to end. But it's virtually an unknown. I mean, everybody takes a guess, but who really knows?
Right. And you know, along those lines, Monty, how are people really coping overall, and how are people pivoting in order to continue to have some sense of livelihood?
Yeah, it's been a range of emotions. You know, everybody is stressed, frustrated, has cabin fever, of course. Although I have been elated by when, for example, I'll pick up a meal to go somewhere at a restaurant, just how courteous and friendly the staff is, and, you know, the customers towards the staff. That has been really gratifying. And, you know, I can't help but wonder, you know, once we do get through this, is the world going to change? Is the world going to be more friendly as a result? Who knows? I certainly hope so. Yes. Cross our fingers.
Yes.
And another thing that we've started doing in Chicago at 8 o'clock each night, one of the local radio stations will play two or three songs that have relevance to what we're going through right now. And people, especially those that live in high rises, will go out on their balconies or at least open up their windows, crank the stereo up to that radio station and sing along and play lights. And it's really been great to be a part of that. And, you know, it's something that I look forward to every day.
Wow. And you know, Chicago is such a large metropolitan area, just to have community built within, you know, the boundaries of the city, which is pretty vast. I mean, that has to be incredible to witness.
It is, and it seems to be growing every night. And you know, I would hope that might be something that might continue in the future after we get through this. Probably not, but hope springs eternal.
Yeah, you know, and certainly our first responders, our medical professionals, and even the people at the grocery store who are themselves on the front lines are deserving of this this wonderful expression of gratitude.
Yeah, I mean, I really try to go out of my way to say thank you to those people who are still working. And when I happen to pass a policeman on the street, I express my gratitude for their service.
Wow. And I'm sure they appreciate that. And maybe in maybe the back of their mind, or, you know, some might be quite shocked because, you know, relationships between the public and police officers.
I have picked up on that. You know, they don't say it directly, but just kind of reading the body language, I can tell sometimes they're a little bit surprised that I say that. But, you know, there's a quick thank you, of course, or, you know, nod of the head. So I do know that they appreciate that.
So Monty, when this thing is lifted, and God only knows when that's going to be, what's the first place you'll go or the first thing you'll do when you have your freedom back?
Wow, Tanya, that's a great question. And a number of things come to mind. Of course, I love the Lake Michigan lakefront here. And that would probably be at the top of my list, you know. And just some of the more mundane things, like just to be able to go out to a restaurant and sit down and have dinner, or go to a concert. And, you know, it's hard to believe, but we're actually, the baseball season should have begun by now. And so I can't wait for the baseball season to start up and to be able to go to a game here in Chicago, the Cubs or the White Sox.
I see you're ready. Yeah,
yeah.
You're on.
I forgot I had this Cubs hat on, but maybe subconsciously I'm more ready than ever for the baseball season to begin.
I'm sure. Well, hopefully we'll see you back here in D.C. visiting old friends too.
Yes, I hope to do that.
Well, thank you, my dear. Thank you so much for spending time with us this afternoon. Stay safe, be well, continue social distancing, and thank you again for joining us. And to our audience,
my pleasure, Tanya. Thanks for having me. Really enjoyed it.
It's my pleasure. And to our audience, be safe, stay at home. It does save lives. And just keep washing his hands and deep breathing. We will get through this together. Thank you for joining us.